Welcome to the Cowboy Judge Show. You know, this internet thing I keep joking about is catching on, Mike. You are a huge marketer. I mean, I try to tell all my friends and colleagues, let me do your marketing. And I sit down with Mike, and I'm like, Mike, I'm a professional internet marketing guy. Let me. And then I see what he does, and I'm like, I think Mike's doing all right on his own.
Yeah, it takes a while.
But he spent a lot of time with it, taught many years at UMSL, the marketing.
Mizzou and UMSL, 14 years. And the biggest catch, I guess, like we'll learn a little bit more about today, is you got to spend money to learn how to do it. That's right. What, you know, you think you could just dive in at your house at 3 in the morning and let things whirl, but really it takes a pocketbook to really get take a hold of it.
And when you say a pocketbook, you're not talking 50, 100, you're talking 150,000.
I think it's changed now, but when I taught about Google AdWords, say, at the last time I did it was June of 14 at UMSL, is I would say you need to spend about 50 grand worth of mistakes on Google AdWords before you understand how to do it right. And I would probably ratchet that up now to, I don't know, 250,000, 150,000 before you know how to get the most return for what you're putting out there. You know, for every dollar you spend, have $2 coming back. It is a pricey endeavor. Once you get it, it's great. The barrier to entry is kind of high, which is good, because once you've got it, for somebody else to come in and take it from you, it's hard.
Right.
You know, they got to have that money.
Well, I've run, that's how we're connected, $100,000 per month accounts,
right,
and some really powerful stuff, and did them myself. And the company I'm with now, that's what they do, and they will take, because most people don't want to spend 50 grand to learn this stuff.
Right.
And you need some expertise, and that's where we all get in our own profession. But we've got an expert here in the building. This is Bert Seal. He is the CEO. I'll go ahead and put his info up on the screen there. The CEO of Incozy. He's done a ton of stuff. As I get to know Bert better, he and I are working on some cool stuff. Former pro golfer, got to be
that's
up in
great.
The, at the time they didn't have the rankings, you said, but up in the top 100 or so, maybe in that range.
Back in the day, make
it,
was.
But made a good living at it for a while. You told me how much, he said, I won't say how much he made, but he said, I only made so much that year. I'm like, that's enough for a lot of people that would do very, very well.
It's funny, you say that old Tony Romo lately has been in the news getting up there in the top 100. Have you seen that?
Playing golf?
Yeah, he almost missed a Sunday night broadcast or something because he was doing so well over in California, I think.
Yeah, I think he made his last cut.
Yeah.
Did he really?
I didn't pay any attention to Tony. Athlete.
Yeah. Well, he went to Illinois State, right, and came out of there.
Romo did?
I think so.
I didn't know.
Wasn't a top-tier school, and then ends up being the quarterback for Dallas Cowboys. Well, we've got a professional, former professional. Do you still play professionally at all?
I don't. I coach my son, and then I coach Matt Kuchar for several years.
Matt Kuchar, he's been one of the top-ranked guys in the world.
Yeah.
Great. But your endeavor, so this is another kind of, I'm between two guys who had other professions that become masters. I'm not joking, Mike. I've never really talked to you about it. You have done things. When I figured out what you've done, I'm like, holy cow. I'm not gonna try to convince Mike he should use me. He's one of those I'll just pass because there's a lot of people who don't have any clue what they're doing, and they need my help. Mike does well. Then I'm running to Bert, and we're hanging out and talking baseball, and I notice his accent, and I'm like, this guy's pretty sharp and what's going on here. But originally born in South Africa, now a United States citizen, and essentially have developed a platform that's rivaling one of the big names out there. You've got, these guys are getting a little, I'll let you talk about whatever you want to, but now to get listed on Google, Mike was talking about, is a tedious and expensive task. You can buy it from Google, which is what they want you to do, and then they change the algorithm so that you can get ranked again. You can try to get ranked for free in the SEO stuff they do, and that they're always changing that, so then that's why they change it, so that you can just buy it from them, right? But that's another task. And then you've got social media, but Incozy now has gotten, your core has been with lawyers.
Well, tell us what that Incozy is first.
Yeah, well, I want Bert to describe it.
So, Incozy is an Uber-like concept for consumers to find on-demand attorneys.
Oh, okay.
At anywhere, any place. Click of a button.
Globally. Okay.
It's a technology company. It took us about 4 years to develop, focusing more on attorneys, younger attorneys that can get on the first page of Google.
Okay.
They would join the platform, pay a small monthly hosting fee, and from there it's free to the consumers to download the app, and wherever they are, the app follows them, similar to Uber.
Okay.
They can get connected immediately.
And what was the genesis of it?
So I've been in the country 29 years, and I've had a lot of lawyer friends in the golfing industry as well.
Okay.
And most
if you're a good golfer, you need a good lawyer.
Most of the biggest concern with attorneys right now, they cannot compete against the big boys. It's just totally impossible. And the way the internet's going today, we tried to build a online platform without the app, and it was just totally impossible. I mean, big companies like Avo, that basically controls the legal side of the internet,
right.
Which is basically just a directory. We are non-directory.
Okay.
We're non-directory, and so we just basically just the software between the consumer and the attorney.
So when you say AVVO and Fine Law, I guess, are directories. You look up, they're alphabetical. You sponsor to be at the top. It's almost like a miniature search engine. Whereas you're saying yours is more of a relationship-driven, or
it's a relationship-driven between the attorney and the consumer trying to find the attorney.
And lots of location.
It's a location-based app.
Okay.
So once you join Ecosia, you get a customized URL.
Oh.
I'll give you an example of that, which is kind of called real estate in cyberspace.
Okay.
And you basically control that zip code. We only select 7 attorneys per law category, per city, and then the club is closed.
Oh.
Yeah. And it works on the rotation, so if you don't pick up the phone, you'll get a text message and an email instantly of that particular potential client.
Okay.
If you don't pick it up, it rolls up to you, to the next attorney.
So how do you get enough folks on Ecosia as consumers to where they can, you know, drive business either globally or regionally?
The challenge for us in the past was not getting the consumer. That was the easy part. The difficult part was getting the attorney.
Oh.
Because it's catch-22. Because now I've downloaded the app and I don't have an attorney in that particular location.
Oh, okay.
So we had to create default attorneys when we started. And after that, now the attorneys are starting to sign up. We also have bail bonds. And personal injury.
Okay.
So if you're looking for a bail bond, Google and Facebook totally blocked all ads of bail bonds in the United States.
Oh, just because they don't like the industry, or?
It's a tough topic, which I don't think I want to get into.
Okay.
There's certain things that Google will not. I sell internet marketing, and there's certain.
I know they blocked like crypto and stuff.
Yeah.
Right.
Guns are often. You can't do guns. Yeah. You can't do. Pornography related things, and then now they're going into other things that they just deem that is not.
There's an opportunity now for a bail agent to join the Ecosia platform.
Okay.
At a small monthly fee, he's basically then the Uber driver waiting for the consumer to find us.
Okay.
The advantage that we have for attorneys, chiropractors, personal injury chiropractors, and bail agents that join us, is we've built a mechanism, and the best way for me to explain it, we are the Trivago. We are the hotels.com.
Okay.
For attorney bail agents on demand. Once you sign up, you get assigned a URL, as I explained to you. And I'll give you an example, wincozy.com/bestDUIattorney,
okay.
David Jones.
Right.
Or wincozy.com/bestpersonalinjuryattorney, Dan Morgan.
Okay.
So you buy that real estate, you rent that real estate, and what happens when Google does the Google search engine results, because we've got so many backlinks, you will now populate on the first page very quickly.
Okay.
Because of the mechanism that this platform is built in.
Well, that's where the small hometown attorney, one or two person attorney, individual, very small office, they don't have the resources to put something together like this. So you've essentially put it together for them, and then they buy their spot from you.
So another interesting part that you just mentioned, that they'll buy it, but we call it the sharing business economy model. So the local painter can now have an opportunity to advertise on the platform and the bio page of the attorney, and vice versa. So now you're creating almost like a little Walmart concept where it's in the community, everybody's sharing and helping each other.
Talk about, you've already partnered with some well-known people. I don't know if you want to drop any names. Or
I can drop a few names. The challenge was in the beginning, I went to a couple of bars, and Judge, you would know each state's different. Then it felt like I was in a different country,
right.
I visited them. And I had to go to the bar associations and find out what the rules and regulations are. And some of these states are very, very tight with referrals. We are totally a non-referral platform.
Okay.
We just the software that we created for the consumer to find you.
So they pay like a licensing fee or something?
You pay a small fee every month, and you got your bio page, you've got your backlinks, The dashboard is very intense, so it saves you time as well. Our new version that we're bringing out now would have an opportunity for the attorney to speak to the client app to app, and have timing time's written down every time you speak to the attorney, and then have a logbook.
Oh.
And then an automatic invoice as well. So that's a cool product that we're launching. And the new version as well, it looks and feels exactly the same as Uber and Lyft, where you as an attorney can now be in St. Louis, if you've got a license and be 50 miles away, you can activate your location, and there might be somebody in the restaurant as well looking for a particular attorney, and then you can start communication immediately.
So, you know, folks watching us, you know, on our Sunday morning show or whichever on ABC, or if I, some of this is on YouTube and Facebook, like most of them are not gonna be attorneys.
Sure.
Most of them won't be painters. Like from the consumer perspective, like what's the advantage of doing an InCozy search as opposed to just a Google search? You know, I think Bing and Yahoo have sunk down to less than 5% market share. Yeah. Google just kicked their butts. Bing was growing up, but so an InCozy is a little bit more, I guess, drilled down, but how do you find it? How do you use it?
I would say InCozy is more like an Instagram and like a Lyft product. It's totally on its own.
Okay.
We've moved away from Google just because of the controlling aspect they have over the small businesses.
Right.
They're all about pay-per-click.
Okay.
And what we're focusing on is just getting the brand out there, and so that InCozy becomes the norm. Think Lyft, think car ride. You know, think Instagram, think sharing pictures. Think InCozy, know your legal rights.
Okay.
So it's just an on-demand platform. How does the consumer know about us? It's the sharing business economy model. Everybody shares it online, and it'll become the norm.
Okay.
Moving forward. It's just a sharing business economy. We focus on every attorney, every Bell agent, any personal injury attorney needs to share the customized URL, otherwise the model will not work.
Yeah, because what I think of pretty quickly is, you know, like LegalZoom, you know, you go to,
correct,
that's its own URL. You could do a search for it pretty,
correct,
quickly, but then, you know, they've gotten the market kind of cornered on, you know, a simple will, a simple quick claim deed, a simple power of attorney,
correct,
you know, I don't know, LLC, I guess. And so I don't know, will InCozy have like document banks and stuff like that too? Or?
No, InCozy is just there for the consumer to reach the attorney and the attorney get that potential new client. The attorney, they answer the questions free for the first time, and then it's for their job to get the second meeting. And
okay.
On our, we've got the app, but we've also got the InCozy.com platform that if you do the Google search, like you said, best DUI attorney or best immigration attorney St. Louis, InCozy will be on the first page simply because of the backlinks that we have. You will now see that particular attorney that is assigned to that territory.
Okay.
And then the nice thing about it is on the web, you can now make contact with the attorney by simply just asking a question.
And so do you have a geographic area now who is has just really metastasized, and you know, everybody in Georgia has InCozy, or a mostly successful region of the country so far?
We're global.
Well, I know that.
Right now we're global. It's every segment is different.
Okay.
I mean, we've got Travis Noble. That's one of the top DUI attorneys.
St. Louis.
He's one of our.
Mike's buddies with Travis. I mean,
right.
I know him. We're not
awesome
buddies, but we wouldn't pass each other.
Was an interesting visit that I had in his office.
Yeah.
He's an interesting guy.
I really
enjoyed it. You know, and so we got Morgan & Morgan. We got Jose Baez, Mark O'Mero. Just big law firms that felt that, listen, they better get on board because it's a niche that in the future people will just be using InCozy and not so much just doing a search on Google.
Yeah, so that becomes, so you don't, and I guess I'm getting it as you say a little bit more about it. So if you want a car ride, you don't Google Lyft, you don't Google,
correct,
Uber, you get on,
correct,
your app, and that's the way that you hail a car.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you can go to Uber.com and probably function on a mobile version of it. I don't know.
Yeah,
but you're saying that as opposed to doing a search for a immigration attorney, they would just turn to their InCozy app.
Correct.
And say, you know, that's where law comes from, is here.
I'm excited to in the bail section as well, and you being a judge, the bail agents right now have got a very tough time locating the defendants. So we've also got a bail bond app, where we do pings and we know the location, you can make payments. And the time-consuming part from, it's pretty cool, that the, we, the, for
I can't
lawyers speaking,
defendants that are
been prosecuted for, potentially being prosecuted, are so hard to find, right?
Well, that's why the Bell Angels do love the app as well.
Yeah.
And with the attorneys, I went through a divorce many years ago, and my biggest concern was when you speak to the attorney, you're speaking to him for 15, 20 minutes, and then suddenly you get a bill. And there was no tracking on that, and we lose track. And he's got a lot of clients. So what we did now with the new version is the attorney can now leave a voicemail. It's almost like WhatsApp. You can leave a voice message for the client back and forth. The two attorneys can now speak to each other and then have a decent log,
okay,
book of what you're supposed to charge your client.
Here's why you can justify that, and here's what
exactly.
You say why you shouldn't have charged
exactly.
as much. But it keeps a fair game for everybody. So the concept, and the other core thing, I started searching some of these attorneys and looking in a certain region. I'm like, wow, there's the other well-known ones, AVO, and then Fine Law, and you were ranked above them or right. in between or on the same page as
right.
them. And I'm going, this is super powerful. And then that's just kind of where it is on the Google side. Translate, what's your plan of attack? I mean, Uber, how did it become such a household product, you know? Yeah. Is that the same approach you're trying
to? We got top engineers that look exactly every single move, and Google changes the whole time, because 15 years ago when AVO, 15, 17 years ago when AVO started, the internet wasn't so advanced. Now it's extremely advanced. You know, if you're an attorney and you're trying to get new business, you, without paying pay-per-click, you're not going to get business.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why they'll use engines like AVO. But AVO's a very expensive directory. And 99% of the consumer on the street doesn't know about AVO.
Right.
They did an extremely good job of getting these attorneys to continuously pay them.
Mm-hmm. Right.
The challenge that we had with Google is, I had a colleague, and he said to me, you know, Google's not going to like what you're doing, because basically you are taking money away. And I said, no, I am just giving customized URLs out. And I think it's fair game to give a customized URL out if an attorney wants to control the whole of Florida personal injury. Well, Google came back and penalized me. They said, you can't do that.
Oh, wow.
I said, why can't I do that? So I said, well, if Morgan & Morgan buys the license to all personal injury in 400 cities in Florida, why cannot he control that segment of market? Google said, nope, you cannot do that. You're duplicating content. So I said, okay, if McDonald's has a head office in Orlando, right, and they nationwide, is that duplicate content?
Right. Yeah, right. Yeah.
Good argument.
Yeah. No, I've come across it before, actually. They hate the duplicate content. They want to make sure you're an independent place. They want to try to keep it as local as possible. So
sure.
That's one of the easier ways for them to kind of flesh it out is to say, hey, if this is the same thing here as it is there, we just want another company there.
Correct.
Yeah. Your colleague was a very insightful
person,
I believe.
He was. And so that was a challenge. It was an eight-month lesson, hard lesson to learn.
Okay.
But right now, we're using big companies like Morgan & Morgan, and we're giving the license to them, but then we're also getting the smaller guy to take over that license in that territory.
Okay.
So then he, Attorney Jones, Attorney Smith, can now take that location, and then I don't know what the next step would be. What Google will say then.
Oh, yeah.
But you've got a pattern. And get to essentially, it's constantly moving, like Google's constantly moving. One of my good friends I won't name, he's one of the top, he's on the Google Roundtable.
Mm.
And I've been doing this stuff for a long time. I think Mike and I talk about it, I think I mentioned it. But last year, out of 882 sales reps in my company, I finished number one for the largest mid-sized marketing company in the country. And I'm terrible at a lot of things, but
right.
I really have many years spent wrapping my head around it. As my parents said, Carter, you're going to have a backup plan in case this baseball career doesn't work out.
Mm.
Very wise. They sent me to computer classes when I was in the eighth grade and made me do that. I protested. I refused to touch a computer after the eighth grade until a senior year in college. But I jumped, it was a good point, but I had my background there. The baseball career ended because, you know, drunk driver, whatever you got going there. My point is, the background you need to truly understand this stuff, you've got to have some incredible depth. That's why I give you guys so much credit, because former pro golfer, current attorney, and judge who've done you guys are way beyond the average people to do that. But for the average consumer, the service you're providing, I mean, I wish I could bottle up what you've learned and pack it and sell it to people, right? You've done an incredible job. Maybe you team you guys up. But what you've got is so unbelievable for the, especially for the small mm-hmm. attorney who's going, I can't afford $2,000 or $3,000 mm-hmm. a month.
Nope.
What can I do for $100, $250? Mm-hmm. And you've got a platform and a way to just get listed and piggyback mm-hmm. on some of the other attorneys, like you're saying.
And there's smaller attorneys and mid-sized attorneys that are spending, mm-hmm. you know, $5,000, $10,000 a week. You'd be surprised
sure.
on, you know, Facebook pushes, pay-per-click, YouTube ranks, which is really incorporated with pay-per-click now anyway, YouTube, but. And you, a lot of times, driving your Google search or your internet activity requires you to do something outside of that, like this TV show or
right.
radio
right.
segments, because people have to start saying, "Oh, I heard that on the radio," you know, and
right.
it all works together. Yeah. It ends up you're $20,000 a week. I mean, that's what I say. When I started talking originally in 03, 04, 05, I was working on, you know, Red Bull and some other, you know, new things sort of at that time. I would say, you know, you need 50 G's, but I think now, if you really are trying to identify and corner a market, it's to your point earlier, I think. I mean, if you start taking it away from them, you know, they're going to push mm-hmm. back if you find a way that's really succeeding.
Yes. That's why we changed. We had to change the business model and focus more on just promoting the app. Yes, we do have the presence on the domain side. And just thinking of your previous question that you were saying, you said, how do we get the name out there? We are now, have within our platform, we are have almost got a Groupon kind of concept as well, where advertisers, the local lawn service, local pool guy, can now advertise on Incozy for free.
Oh, okay.
And then they would share their URL.
Right.
And that's essentially how this viral stuff starts, and so how a company like Uber comes out of nowhere and everybody says, hey, why don't you Uber it?
Correct.
And nobody, I never saw an ad for Uber, right? Nobody put a public display of Uber, but it spread by word of mouth. So you're literally, and I know I help the audience understand, you've got your page, and on that page, other related things that they're
tied to.
They're trying to promote themselves by saying, see my link here,
correct.
They're also going to see the people that have joined in to collaborate
correct.
Together, create a little
correct.
Community of people that all work together, yeah. and it's just going to push the whole thing.
Well, the local dry cleaning, it's impossible for them to become the norm. Impossible. But now they are affiliated with Incozy as well. And that dry cleaner will use the lawyer.
Right, right.
And vice versa, be it the pool guy, be it the, and then the segment of that zip code. Now we've got the people, now we've got the community pushing the domain up, and it becomes the norm at the end of the day.
Yeah, I like it.
Well, to me, this is one of those cool revolutionary type things that you just run into people like this. And Bert had enough appreciation for what I was kind of sharing with him about my background, and so I we've talked a little bit, and I just love collaborating with him on this, and I think what he's got going there is really going to make a difference. And because, like I see time and time again, I spend quite Mike and I are always going back and forth. I'm saying, Mike, what if we can bring people on the show and give them this kind of exposure, and then we'll get to help these smaller businesses really get a foothold on what they are otherwise pushed out of the market with. When you're talking small attorneys spending $5,000 a month? Wow, I kind of
believe. Week.
A week?
Yeah, I wouldn't doubt it. I mean, if they're trying to grow, I mean, yeah, it takes that pretty readily. Not to mention the woman and man hours, you know, to try to do it on your own if you're an attorney, billing at $200 an hour, $400 an hour. Every minute you're doing accounting and internet SEO is times you're not doing briefs or in court, you know. It gets pretty, not cost prohibitive, but it's the learning curve steep and that kind of thing.
And so then there's other endeavors tied into this. What are the other industries that you're going to, as this continues to grow? I know you talked to me a little bit about real estate.
So we're using the same mechanism, and we've got another company called NETtimes.com, which is in the golfing community. We've got over 11,000 golf courses in that platform.
Oh, wow.
Over 9,500 affiliated pros. So that ties in as well, because now I can use that platform introducing Incozy as well. I've got another platform called FUSC, which is where juniors that are trying to get a scholarship and trying to get exposure, they can use that platform as well.
College, high school kids going into
correct.
College.
Yeah. And then we've got the real estate one that we're creating that'll launch second week of February, which is exactly the same as Incozy, which is also on demand. How many times have we driven in a neighborhood and we like the house, we want to rent the house, and you call the real estate agent, she doesn't pick up. So with Incozy right now, you'll have every single real estate in that zip code that's either active now and a ping will go out and whoever answers first will get that potential client.
Yeah, that sounds pretty good. How the name InCozy, does it have any significance? Is it an acronym or what is that?
So I had a challenge, it means chief.
Chief?
In Zulu, yes. And I have a couple of my buddies say, but nobody's gonna remember. And it took me a while. I'm in trouble and they make me cozy.
Okay.
I
need an attorney now and they're gonna make
me
cozy.
Well, he was saying InCozy and stuff, but I hadn't looked it up, you know, and, yep. But once you see it and put it together, I think it does have a little bit more impact. It becomes more of like a Kleenex type of thing. You know, right. We go to get Kleenex for tissue and stuff.
Exactly.
So everything can become that secondary meaning. And right. Visually, that once you see InCozy, it sounds less like a foreign-tongued word, you know what I mean?
Right, sure.
And more like some kind of cutesy name like Amazon or something, you know what I mean?
Right, yeah. Amazon, and it took me a long time to realize they take an arrow between A and some other point.
The smiley face?
Yeah, and it's actually the A points to the Z, so it's everything between A and Z.
Oh, is it?
For Amazon. A lot of people may not have read. I haven't mentioned that to anybody, so if you didn't know that, yeah, look at it. Everything's from A to Z because they've got that two letters in the. So InCozy, you're going to get InCozy with the people that are going to take care of you to make sure. So what's next? Now you're filling this with lawyers right now. You're also doing bail bondsmen?
Bail bondsmen. We're focusing on bail bondsmen as well, and then we're also focusing on the real estate side so that they can also.
But the real estate one won't be on InCozy. It might have its own name, or
it'll have its own name. Yes.
Okay.
It's going to.
But
have
on
its own
InCozy
name.
Will be mostly everything legal related.
Correct. You know, before closes, et cetera. You know.
And I've talked to you. I won't pin you down with pricing right now because I know that could change a little bit. It's super inexpensive compared to some of the other stuff that's out there.
Right.
But now is the time to get in, right? That's why you've got some big name guys who've thrown at you. I know you told me some numbers. I'm like, that's a lot of money to put in. But they want to buy the big component and then let the other guys fill in some of their stuff and then they'll work together, you're talking about. But if you're a smaller startup attorney or even an attorney or even a big attorney, get in now. Much like Google, it'll start off at this level and may end up being, if you wait, it's going to be prices go up.
The advantage is if you get in now, you get that customized URL. Yep. And once you get the customized URL, it's yours.
And to be clear, when you were blacklisted at some point, whatever, but you reprogrammed it, and I tested all these URLs you gave me, and they're back ranked. I didn't know.
I wouldn't say I was black, I was just punished.
Yeah.
I was punished by Google because Google felt that, listen, here's somebody that we haven't heard of, and suddenly, if an attorney Googles his name or puts in personal injury or consumer, then InCozy's on the first page, and that's not good.
Yeah,
I don't pay for pay-per-clicks.
Yeah, and that's
and
what I'm saying.
None of my customers do. It's going to change the model now, and I had to change the model. Yeah, this colleague, what I won't mention, that you also know, by the way, did tell me that, listen, you Google is going to punish you, and which they did. And I got top engineers out there, and it's just not worth the battle.
Yeah. Okay. And as I say, my SEO buddy, I mean, he can get anything ranked. They get incredible amount, and it can be done. You just have to have the expertise to get it done.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Thank you very much. Mike, was this right up your alley? I'd say this is something that you have got so much.
Yeah, I mean, we do a lot of it, you know. I'm probably not as open to stuff as I was a couple of years ago because things have really taken off, but we do a lot.
Well, absolutely. Just from a general, this is, I mean, you understand this is where it's got to be going.
Yeah.
It's for small business.
If you can get an app that people think of a legal question like an Uber, you'll be on the right track.
This is good. Thank you, Bert, for joining us on
the show
today.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
You've been watching the Cowboy Judge Show. Giddy up.